Here's another mode that we just wanted to really just kind of tease you guys about here, but there's a... there it is right there. You can see it. You can see the mode right there. It's the gallery. So we have this gallery with all this different information. People are really going to analyze this now, too. That's cool, though. That's cool. And you can see in the gallery here, we have all this different stuff that you're going to be able to see specific information on in the game. And you'll be able to view the models. So hold on, 1 second. Hold on. Because there's still one other thing we're going to say before we move on to the Devil Breakers.
Devil Breakers, before we move on to the mode.
そうですね。
もう一つここで初めて発表するモードがあります。トレーニングモードがあります。
Another thing, a lot of people have been asking on Twitter stuff, like, is there going to be a training mode? Is there going to be a training mode? All right, well, again, we're going to officially reveal that, yes, there is a training mode in the game.
今まで要望はあったんですけど、ちょっと余裕なくてつけられなかったんですけど、今回頑張ってつけたので。
And Yusuf-san says, look, that we, this is something that people have been asking for a long time, training modes. And so, you know, we've tried our best. There were certain titles where we weren't able to get that done correctly.But this time we made sure to make the effort, and there's going to be a training mode. So we'll reveal more details on that one in due time.
In due time.
Good question. I don't think we've actually figured out when we're going to reveal details, actually.
この中で TGS 来る人いるんですかね?
Is anybody, actually, that's a good question. Is anyone going to be at TGS here, from here? Anybody?
Oh, nice.
Man, you guys are hardcore. Yeah. Man, nice. All right.Cool, well, thank you. Come see us, say hi. You know? Hi. All right. Sorry, Charlie. Right.
Oh, no, no worries. Oh. This is all great stuff. So, some of the other concepts we're going to show off, we're going to talk about Nero's Devil Breakers. But we're going to start with so, we all have weekly conference calls. I talk to Matt quite a bit. And we talk, one of the things that we talk about is art assets and, you know, things that we can do to, like, make the fans really happy. And,This is actually one of the first art concepts that I got to see come in. And you can see it in its raw form of how a concept art happens for a poster. So this is, you can see it's roughly Nero and all of his Devil Breakers. But it's really cool, the final piece of art. I love this piece of art so much. Yeah, it's infinitely amazing.But what you can see here is, so if you played the demo, you've encountered Overture and the Gerbera arms, but there's a lot more Devil Breakers here. So we are actually going to talk a little bit more about all of these tools that Nero can use. So what do you say we, like any goodmusical movement. Let's start with the overture, shall
Ooh,
we?
Ooh, she went there, yes.
You thought nice you were safe.
No, man, I'm never safe. Overture, there we go. Yep, so this is the first one. オーバチュアについて何か。
オーバチュアというのは、ニコが一番最初に作ったデビルブレイカーで、まあ、オーバチュアっていうのは英語でそのまま分かるんですよね。始まりの。
So,Really, Overture is the overture of Devil Breakers as far as Nico is concerned because it's the first one that she ever made. And so for her, it's just the beginning. It's just the overture of the whole ensemble that she's got planned.
ちゃんと変形するようになってますんで。
You can see that in the videos that we have there, in the model viewer, you can actually see how they transform, the Devil Breakers transform there, as we just showed now.
And いる場所によってね、出る方向が変わるんですよね。
You'll see with this standard Devil Breaker Overture move here called Battery that depending on the state of your enemy there, the direction that Nero actually does the battery and change there. So you see sometimes it's on the ground, sometimes in front of him, sometimes it's above him like that.
All right, now let's go to our next one, which you can also find it in the demo if you play it down at the Capcom or the Microsoft booth. We have the Gerbera.
Gerbera.
はい、ガーベラはこれ展開した状態、これもちゃんとパーツが変形して展開するんですけど、この展開したのがガーベラという花の形によく似ているので名前がガーベラと言います。
And so the idea with Gerbera is that, as you can see here, when it's open like this, when it's doing its breakage moves, which are the kind of charge moves that you can do with the Devil Breakers, that it's supposed to kind of look like a flower called the Gerbera, a Gerbera.So that's where it gets its name from. And then as you can see here, the break age move, the power move for this, there's two of them. This one here is called stem ray.
Stamen ray.
Oops. Guess I've forgotten my, my flower.
You forgot your botany
flower
class.
Flower structures there. There you go. And then petal ray here. So there's two. Depending on whether you're on the ground or you're in the air, you do a different move. And so, yeah, we kind of based those moves on the image of a stamen, for a Gerberus stamen, and a Gerberus petals here.
Awesome. Yeah. Now, here's another double breaker that you guys might have seen from watching the trailers.
All right. Punchline.
Yes. Punchline. Yes. まだそんなにちゃんと発表してないやつで今回初めて名前言うかと思ってパンチラインですね。
Yeah, I think this might be the first time that we've actually revealed the official name for it. But yep, this is Punchline. And it becomes a rocket.
ちゃんとあの上に乗れるように足を乗せられるようになってるんですね。
You see, when it's open there, you can see actually the spot that, Nero's able to step on when he's riding. Yeah! Round him, cowboy!
それでね、ぜひアメリカの人たちに中二という言葉を覚えてもらいたいんですよ。
You know, this is very in Japanese we say 中二. This is very 中二. It's the kind of stuff that people in their early teens think is badass. And that is exactly what Itsuno-san goes for in all of his games, is this kind of 中二 feeling. And yes, Nero's pro skater, there you go.
Yes.
Maybe we should make like an iOS game or something like that. With, and there will be Nero's Pro Skater with the rocket, with the punchline.
Yeah.
Yeah, man.
Oh, it's so badass. All right, let's go to our next one, which is also a reveal. And we were talking about this one a lot last night. We're talking about the Tomboy.
Ooh, Tomboy.
Tomboy. Tomboy っていうのは、あの、日本語だとね、あの、おてんば娘とかじゃじゃ馬とかっていうその扱いきれないようなあのまあ男の子っぽい女の子のことを言います。
So, tomboy, you know, when we say tomboy in English, we talk about women who maybe exhibit more what you might consider, some people might consider more masculine traits, more masculine features in their personality.
で、トムボーイ自体は、ですね、ここに伸びてるこのアームのほうが本当はもっと長く伸びて、銃弾を加速させて、より強力な、弾にする能力と、もう一つは、このアームがあのレッドクイーンにつながってレッドクイーンにエネルギーを供給しつつここの手がねちょうどモンキーレンチみたいになってて、レッドクイーンの下をギュッと掴んで両手持ちの剣として暴れまくる剣で切るとこれ2つともねロックオンできないっていうのがこのトムボーイな理由です。
I'm going to explain a lot here, so bear with me for a second. So...That's how we think of the name tomboy, the word tomboy in English, right? Or at least some people might. But in Japanese, we kind of take that and our image of that word in Japanese becomes more something that a woman who is not going to be stopped by convention, is going to break past the convention, okay? And so the tomboy then has these two parts.On the double breaker. One is this thing, you saw the thing that kind of hangs over the top. The idea with that is that that is going to help accelerate the bullets that come out of the Blue Rose even more. And then there's this kind of monkey wrench thing on the bottom that he can use with the Red Queen, and that's going to really power up the Red Queen. So the idea here is that Tomboy powers up the Blue Rose and the Red Queen so much so thatNero can't control it because it's so powerful. It's gone so much past the conventional use of Blue Rose and Red Queen. And so, because this is so powerful, because he can't control it, you can't lock on to enemies when you use this thing. So that's kind of the interesting gameplay mechanic that you have with the Tomboy.
So cool. It doesn't bow to society's conventions. I love it.
Yes, exactly.
So next
just like
we
Charlene.
Have...
Just like Charlene.
Yes.
Yes.
And another new reveal, we have the ragtime.
Yes, ragtime. And so this is Nero's time stopper. So their idea is that there is demonic power housed within this devil breaker. And you might be wondering, well, how do they do that? How does he get that demonic power? Well, that's something that we're going to find out when the game comes out. So please check that out. But as you can see here, the idea is that it stops time. And so this gives you a chance to, as Nero, to walk around the enemies, apparently. And gives you a chance to experiment with what you're going to do with your combos when the enemies are frozen in place. Taking a stroll, yep. With his little time stopper move.
Yeah. All right, now we have another one. This one's got the coolest name, not gonna lie. The Helter Skelter.
Yes. All right.
このヘルタースケルターっていうのは、まあ、螺旋状の、まあ、遊園地にある螺旋状の滑り台をヘルタースケルターって言うんですけど、そこから名前をつけています。
So I'm sorry, maybe, I don't know, actually, no, maybe we do this in America as well, but in Japan anyways, when you have like a kind of screw-like slide, we call that Helter Skelter. And so Helter Skelter then, the shape of the Helter Skelter like this, kind of resembles that shape. So that's where we got the name from.
これ実はあの変形、このドリル状のやつが1段階展開したときは、ドリル状のまま展開して、ここの映ってる2段階目のやつはもう最終段階なんですね。本当は間にもう1段階。あるんですけど、あのドリルで切り刻んだ最後にこの3つ目の形に展開して僕らシュレッダーって言うんですけど、もう切り刻むっていう形で。
And so, this is pretty graphic, but yeah, so it's a drill. It's this drill, and so there's actually three different stages where the drill opens up. And you just drill harder and harder in there, and as you get deeper and deeper, another stage of that drill opens up until you've just massacred those demons. They probably deserve it anyways. And so while you're doing this, you'll actually want to keep jamming on the if it's an Xbox controller, it's going to be the B button as fast as you can, as much as you can, in order to basically get all three of those stages out with the Helter Skelter.
Oh, it's absolutely brutal. It reminds me of like a garden tool. Those garden tools that you like
right.
break. Yeah.
Right.
But this is cooler. This is cooler than gardening.
It is. Well, I mean, yeah. A garden tooler might not be as effective against demons, but I don't know. I mean,
You work with what you got, Matt. You work with what you got.
That's true. But yeah. You do that so well, Charlene.
Thank you. Well, let's look at one more. I love this one. Rawhide.
はい、これロハイドですね。これね、先がこうハサミになってるんですけど、これがねちゃんとこう分かるかな、こう根元の分かるかな、こうペロペロペロちゃんとこの形に変形するようになってるんですよ。
アコーディオンとか。
He's gonna make me do this, isn't he?
アコーディオン系ではない。
Yes.
So アコーディオン的な感じ。
アコーディオン、うん、そうはちょっと違う。
It's going to open up. So as you can see, there's the closed state and then there's the open state, right? And so those all fold on top of each other. Pedal, pedal, pedal. Like that. And it becomes this crazy whip, as you can see here. Yeah! Woo! Adam Cowboy! Yeehaw! Yes. We're not done, though.
Oh,
one more
better.
Here, Nero. There you go. Yeah. That is the power of Itsuno.
この振り回すやつはすごい強いやつやから、一回使ったら壊れちゃう技です。
The one that he uses where he picks up the enemy and then he's able to kind of whip him around like that. That's actually the break age move. That's gonna be the one that it's so powerful that it the double breaker breaks, as you can see here after using it.
That's so awesome. All right, so now that we've learned about all of our devil breakers, it wouldn't be a Devil May Cry event if we didn't do a special mission and all of you are participating. So are Nero and Nico around? Where are Nero and Nico? Where did they go? Oh, there
they
are.
Coming from the back.
So did everybody get a little